Hello, my name is Alexander Knyazev, and the theme of my presentation is the image sharpness estimation and the CNN training enhancement in the empty containers recognition system of reverse vending machine. We propose an approach to the development of the original neural network. This network is a part of a small waste container. To solve the sorting problem, a neural network must classify two types of objects: plastic bottles and other objects. This neural network should provide the restrictions that the sortomat imposes: low computing power, insufficient, a short time for processing the input information, less than 1 second to classify one photo, and the correct classification of geometrically deformed objects. With transfer learning technology, AlexNet, SqueezeNet, and MobileNet neural networks were trained. The lowest error, 7%, is given by MobileNet neural network. But evaluating this network online using a web camera, neural network classifies images incorrectly if recognized object is far from the camera, not vertical, lit not evenly, or contains lamp flickers. To increase the accuracy of online classification for training the MobileNet neural network, data augmentation was applied. The idea of this technology is supplementing the training set with data by means of various transformations: rotation, padding, scaling, etc. Each item has general and private information. Private information is valid for a specific subject, general for all subjects. General information is the environmental impact, OSI, on an item. Each item is subject to different OSIs, for example, lighting, background, contamination of an item, deformation of an item, etc. Being able to extract as much as possible general and private information about the subject, the number of images of this subject needed for training can be reduced to 1. But even when applying this type of transformation, the neural network is not able to correctly classify objects with high level of geometric transformations, for example, crushing. The presented work proposes our own philosophical idea of extracting and transferring information about objects, which will allow training neural networks on a small amount of data. We have to apply the scientific approach to consider which kind of data augmentation is suitable and is efficient for our CNN training. Such a problem is mathematically named as the risk minimization for learning theory. In this equation, theta is the applied image preprocessing kind, phi is the width of the neural network, and L is the function of the accuracy of the neural network evaluation. The mathematical solution of the problem is to find theta, which is the minimum mathematical expectation of the function L, is achieved among the set of problems tau. In this article, by set tau, we mean the set of test samples. Several experiments were performed for the following combination of data augmentation. First, normalizing of lighting. This normalization allows us to achieve greater resistance to changes in image brightness. Second, subtraction from the image pixels of the average intensity calculated from the sections of the original image. Such normalization helps to achieve better results in the case of background instability. Third, blurring the image to reduce noise, which gives better camera noise immunity. We can use this kind of augmentation separately or use combinations of them. Each case is binary coded by presence or absence of corresponding augmentation kind. 0, no augmentation for this kind. 1, application of augmentation of this kind. This code is parameter theta. For example, binary value 100, decimal 4, corresponds to the third augmentation, boring, was applied and the others not applied. The training and testing process of the mobile net with different theta was performed using the following stages for each theta. First, application of the corresponding augmentation kind coded by theta for the training set of CNN. Second, mobile net training on an enlarged training sample using cross-validation on 10 folds and cycling training. Third, estimation the results for each of the trained neural network on each fold for each test set according to the metric of accuracy. The mobile net neural network model was trained using the Keras framework on cloud TPU facilities. There using the evaluation no method in the convolutional neural network equation,
therefore, the optimal solution for theta for the neural network
was obtained
of a convolutional neural
table
network.
On this
which
slide
converts
shows the image
95%
allowed by
the recurrent neural network
estimates
which
for
performs
each of
the
conversion
prediction
of
and
the visible
each
object.
Of the augmentation
when evaluating
being
this
used.
Neural network,
it was found
augmentation
that
it correctly
subtracts
images
from
the image
photo
picks
as
the
same
of the average
intensity.
To eliminate the drawback noted above, the neural network was modified for the use of one-shot learning, namely the Siemens network. A developed neural network of 700 photos of cans, 700 photons of bottles, and 6,000 photos of other objects was trained. This set includes crumpled and even bottles and cans that are photographed with the same background but from different angles. The proposed neural network reached 0% error rate in the training set and the same rate in the test set. An important factor for recognition is picture quality. If the camera is damaged or the lens becomes dirty, the picture may be unfocused and blurred. The method for the blur detection based on the Laplacian estimation. After processing a grayscale image, a Laplacian value is obtained at the output, which is compared with a threshold value. If the obtained value is below the threshold, the image is blurry. If it is higher, the image is normal. This approach determines the blurred image because of Laplacian identifies those areas of the image which contain sharp changes in intensity. It can be used to highlight edges. If there are few edges in the image, then it's blurry. If the dispersion is high, we decide that the image contains a large number of sharp changes, which means it is not blurry. Using a large subset of different object images from cameras, we can calculate or calibrate the threshold value. To do this, blurry unfocused picture and pictures in focus are processed. As a result, we obtain a threshold value which helps us to detect blur images if this value is exceeded. This approach allows us to diagnose cameras. This is necessary to ensure the correctness of neural network detection results. If the image from one of the cameras is detected blurry, operator will receive a notification that the camera is malfunctioning. In this case, you need to check the lens or replace the camera.
The aforementioned functions the neural were network tested script, on an image set object detection function with various quality and focus neural network, as if well as containing the object or not is empty. The average operating to determine the presence of an object were compared. Perceptual hashes were taken on a Raspberry Pi and the image of empty compartment. The test results are as Hamming distance between. Compared with the convolutional neural network, the advantage of the developed neural network that implements the proposed idea is the correct classification of objects on backgrounds other than the backgrounds of the training set. But with architecture does not fully realize the idea of building the network described in this work. Further research areas include conducting experiments with other types of data augmentation, applying attention technology for neural networks, developing a meta-learning algorithm for a neural network. These studies should lead to great robustness, adaptation to change in lighting and background, and finally to strong AI. Let's discuss some TPC questions. Number one, can you discuss any additional use cases where your system might be utilized? Well, our approach significantly speeds up the recognition processing and increases the CNN accuracy. In the case of faulty cameras, or blurred images of the empty compartment. Of course, there can be thousands of cases of the computer vision technology and object recognition utilization, where the decrease of useless CNN running cycles according to verification results could help to reach the computational efficiency. Number two. Can you discuss computational complexity in case the system is to be applied to the different target hardware? Can we be sure it would run correctly? Well, it takes significantly less time to perform the verification rather than running the neural network script on the Raspberry Pi microcomputer. We prevent running CNN with the incorrect input images, blurred image for the motion or image containing no objects, and avoid delays and useless processing. If the input data is incorrect, we have to run CNN for the second time to process the correct image, and this leads us to an unsatisfactory delay for nearly 2 additional seconds. This approach can be ported to any platform both based on CPU or CPU plus GPU, because the single convolutional of the input image using 3x3 core is less expensive than the CNN processing with hundreds of convolutions. Thank you for your attention.